I'm Andy.
We are at Atlassian, and this week we have been doing all the baskets.
Baskets, all the baskets. Some of the important things we spoke about with baskets is making sure that we maintain stretch and momentum. As always, it helps with a lot of swing dance moves.
And follows, I'm going down my line and I do not deviate. The lead's job is to get out of my way, but don't make that movement too big. So stay close to your follow, but just make sure that you've given just enough room for them to pass you by in a straight line without having to deviate.
That's right. So you try to make sure that as a lead, we get the follow to go in a straight line, and we just do the travel from left to right according to which
going. So a basic basket starts in double hand hold, and the way you can do that is to get into that rather is from a swing out.
So if we did a basic swing out.
5, 6, 7, 8. You notice Andy's letting my hand drape down his arm on the way out of the swing out, which tells me to go to double hand hold.
If the follower doesn't get the sign, or we're a little bit late as a lead and we think, oh, I really want to do that, that's okay. We can kind of do this really obvious at this point.
And then I'll take it.
There's really not much option for the follower if my hand is not ready. If it catches me,
yeah.
I'm going, plate of pizza,
take it.
Take my hand.
So the basket goes like this. We have a stretch, triple step,
stretch, triple step.
Those two stretch points are really important, that the follow is trying to go forwards until they are redirected back, and then I'm trying to go back until I'm redirected forwards. So
once more, nice and slowly. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Cool. So then after we practiced that, we did some variations.
Very quickly as well, we did an exercise very briefly about stretch, which is a sort of a cheeky swing out move. Basically, you can do a regular swing out. And if you want to practice stretch.
Good exercise for the followers to practice going down their line without stopping, thinking you know that what's coming next because you don't.
That's right. Always actually fun to use actually in a swing.
It's kind of a little bit of a move from the lead.
It is.
Like, oh, you're not paying attention, so
no,
use it sparingly.
I use it in a cheeky way, not in a derogatory way, right?
Yeah.
So that said, back to the thing. So we spoke about other types of variations. So we have our basic, and then we have a spinning release, drop the left hand.
And the reason I know that I'm spinning out is because I feel the ribs. So the hand on the arm on the ribs, and that asks me to turn. I can only turn one direction.
That's right. Even in this move, I'm still traveling backwards. I bring the follow back, I release my hand.
This is a 6-count exit as well.
Usually. 8.
Oh, okay.
8
you
release.
You end up with a couple of counts,
you've got
to fill at the end.
Ah, it ends where it ends. from here, we can do a basic like free spin.
Or whatever you like to get back into the right hand.
Yep. The next one was a
reverse.
So if we did a basic basket, we bring our leads, we bring our hand, karate chop, drop downwards, like so.
And that means that I'm going to put my hand to hand, which sets us up in this arm position, which will allow me to travel down the other side.
That's right, and we're going to be bringing the follows down our left side leads. So, and then we'll bring them through like so. Catch, stretch, release. And again, we're in this funky hand hold here.
Yep.
We do an American spin or a free spin.
Notice the follow still goes in a dead straight line, both in and out.
So all the way through, it looks like so.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Cool. And the final one was the around the front.
Yes, so this one we might do from the front. This one might, hang on, this is wrong. Looks like so.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So I'm going straight out, straight back. Andy is swatting into my side and he's really close. So I can feel his shoulder and I can feel his hip.
Definitely close, and making sure that the follow travels back towards the lead. It's not an abrupt shunt or anything like that, it's just a collect. And then from there we do a rock, step, triple step, step, triple step, and release.
So again, because I'm going to commit to my direction from the wrap up, from there, Andy leads me backwards, rock, step, and then he leads me forwards. And I'm going to try
forwards.
And go forwards in a straight line, and then he slots around the other side and leads me back.
I also get some travel from the follow in that as well. So the follow will do a bit of bump, shum, beat up, but probably half of, we're basically sort of switching sides a little, as opposed to me making the follow or me doing the travel. Another important tip as well is don't do a rock, step, and roll in that position.
Ah, yes.
That's something else, that's a release.
And that will ask me to turn.
If I try to do that all the way through with this movement, it'll look like this. Ugh, it gets a little bit shapeless and funky.
Yeah.
So we try to make sure it's straight, forwards, back, release. You can do as many of those as you like without actually releasing, and then you can decide if you want to release it.
Yeah. That's it. Thank
That's
you very
it.
Much.